In the press conference yesterday, there was a lot of talk about gun control. And if Joe Biden gets rid of the filibuster and he goes after guns, it is going to tear the country apart. I mean, you cannot take away the AR in today's world. That is the modern sporting rifle. It is what people use when they go hunting. It is what you use for sports. You don't use grandpa. It's like, honestly, it's like going from, I'm trying to think of something that people who don't shoot would understand, but I don't think those people understand any. I mean, they still call, you know, a magazine a clip. I heard somebody
I don't know. Maybe I'm in the minority here. I grew up in the Northeast. We were not around guns. My dad was in the military, but we were not around guns at all. I would, without doing this stupid show every day, I would not know the difference between a magazine and a clip either. I don't think there's a lot of
a
gun person, how do you even is talk different about, than like, yeah,
how do you talk to people who don't have any interest in even learning there's a difference between a magazine and a clip?
Yeah, it's difficult. I mean, like, you know, famously, you know, Bloomberg, who's spent more money to try to take your guns than anybody else in the country.
And yet carries one.
And of course, has security and carries one. But he was talking about an automatic weapon and didn't know the difference between automatic and semi-automatic. I mean, that's an even more fundamental, obvious thing you need to know. And he didn't even know that.
So the difference between going from a modern sporting rifle and the one with the wood that, you know, like they used in World War II. It's like going from, you know, one of those black scary pistols that you always see, like with James Bond, that everybody has now, to a cowboy gun. I mean, it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. Now, there are things going on that you can get involved with, and I urge you to get involved locally and at your state level to protect the Second Amendment. I wanted to talk to State Senator Tom Corbin of South Carolina, because what they're doing in South Carolina is fantastic. You have an unorganized militia already, and it's been there since the beginning of the country, right?
Yes, go ahead.
Yes. Hi, Tom.
Hi, good morning. Thank you so much for having me on the show.
You bet.
Yes, our state constitution has in it, in Article 13, Section 1, it has lined out a citizenry militia that's been in our state constitution since its inception.
Okay, and I've been to South Carolina. I'm trying to remind Stu. I think he was with me. One time when I was in South Carolina, I went into this place, and it's almost like a museum, but it's also, they still meet there. It's a militia headquarters, and they have the registration book that is still in practice today, signed by George Washington. I mean, you guys have had...
I did not know that.
Oh, yeah. It's an amazing place. But anyway, you guys have had a militia from the beginning. So what are you doing to fight against the gun grab here?
Well, that's a great question. And there have been other bills sponsored in the General Assembly in South Carolina. For example, there's one dealing with a Second Amendment sanctuary state, okay? Mm-hmm. And I co-sponsored that bill. But basically what that bill does is that if the Attorney General determines that a law coming out of Washington or an executive order is unconstitutional, then no state funds can be expended to enforce it. You know, which is great. I mean, that's somewhat of a pushback against Washington.
Right.
But I always wanted to pass a law creatively that would ensure and give comfort to the people that I serve that Washington could not come down here and confiscate any of the weapons that we legally possess now. That was the goal of this bill. So when I was thinking about how to do that, and I'll be honest with you, I collaborated with Dr. Edwin Vieira Jr., who's a constitutional scholar, mm-hmm. and I was trying to make this a great bill, had a lot of help from staff in Columbia. But the idea was, when you look at previous Supreme Court rulings and you look at the United States Constitution, which says in the Second Amendment, a well-regulated militia, comma, being necessary to the security of a free state, comma, and these commas are important, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. you and I understand that that the part about our Second Amendment not being infringed, and infringed means that to act so as to limit or undermine something. That's the definition of infringed.
Right.
Okay. So you and I understand that that means the citizens of this nation. Okay. But sometimes Washington can be scary in the way they think. So what I wanted to do was craft legislation that would actually it would mesh and it would layer. It would give layers of protection. So because we have what is deemed an unorganized militia, in South Carolina, you're either, if you reside here, you are a member of the National Guard, the State Guard, and if you're not a member of one of those, then you are in the South Carolina unorganized militia.
You're automatically, as a citizen of South Carolina.
As a citizen.
Okay.
That's correct. Yes, right. Exactly. So when the Supreme Court has looked at the Second Amendment, they always look at it in terms of, well, does the Second Amendment apply to every citizen or just to the militias? Okay. Well, they've always determined it applies to the citizenry, which is great, which is what it does, and they should do that. Well, suppose that a law was passed or an executive order that went back up to the Supreme Court, any sort of confiscation, and they did decide that it was only the militia. Okay, this bill would then still protect every citizen of South Carolina because we are in a militia. All I had to do was go in and define what the armament or weaponry of that militia was. And that's all the bill does. People have a misconception. They think we're forming a militia and, you know, we're trying to start a militia, things like that. That's not it at all. All this bill does is define the weaponry of the militia. And that's in Section 2. It says an unorganized militia member at his own expense shall have the right to possess and keep all arms that could be legally acquired or possessed by a South Carolina citizen as of December 31st, 2020. And that date was just picked at random, Glenn. Mm-hmm. I could use today's date, okay? This includes, but is not limited to, shouldered rifles and shotguns, handguns, clips, magazines, all components and all ammunition fitted for such weapons. It's really a very brief bill, a to-the-point bill, but it's designed to prevent the federal government from ever confiscating anything that we can legally have now because of the way it's crafted. They are the armament of our militia, and the government cannot disarm a state's militia or a standing army in a state.
Well, you might be the only one, because I don't know how many states have a state militia like that. Do you know?
I honestly don't know. I would think that some states, particularly those that were, you know, involved with the Revolutionary War at the time, or these areas, you know, along the coast, would have some sort of provision like that. Mm-hmm. I haven't really researched other states. Some may do, some may not. But that was the uniqueness of South Carolina that I discovered, and I felt like through all of the collaboration with all the wonderful people who helped me with this bill, that would be the best way to approach any sort of gun confiscation.
Right.
I love the idea of sanctuary states, Second Amendment sanctuary states.
That's a speed bump. What you do is what the sanctuary state movement means, and it's really important, is that it says no state resources. So the local law enforcement, nobody can help the federal government take guns away. But it doesn't stop the federal government from coming in and doing it themselves. Yours does, because you say, exactly. Wait a minute. No, this is, you have actually state resources that can be used to stop the federal government from doing that, correct?
Exactly.
Right.
These weapons that we possess are part of the weaponry of our organized and standing and well-regulated militia here in South Carolina.
One last question for you. I didn't hear bullets or ammunition in that list.
I glazed over it, and I'm so sorry.
Okay.
In the last sentence, it says all components and all ammunition.
Okay, good.
Good,
good, good. Yeah, that's all right. Senator Tom Corbin from South Carolina, thank you so much for what you're doing. And, gosh, we may be counting on the people of South Carolina. Thank you.
Well, I hope other states have. And thank you, Glenn. You're a true patriot. Thank you so much for what you do.
You bet.